say that if I have any burgers on board, besides you, Bob, if I have any burgers on board, this is a really good time to let the crew know. Now, 6 hours is going to fly by, but your burger, and there's a specific burger you hope to see, I can try and carve out a little bit of time to show you some of the burgers that are harder to find. Now, you don't have to worry. Puffins and polymers. As we approach Kingshead here, I just looked up ahead of me here, we have our first marine mammals of the day. Come on out. Our first marine can actually reach speeds of 21 miles an hour and drop their core temperature 2 to 3 degrees to dive down to about 1,000 feet. And also reach speeds of, again, 21 miles an hour. Now they haul out because they're... Again, we're just going to drift here for a little bit. I just want to briefly explain what's happening, and then we'll talk about it in detail once we leave. Essentially, you have two animals that are workers. They are actually working together, communicating underwater and creating a cylinder. Inside the cylinder are pairing. Now they're creating this cylinder using bubbles from their nostrils. Yeah, literal bubbles. Not small bubbles, big bubbles, 1 to 3 feet. Once the cylinder of bubbles is set and the fish are all trapped inside, one will trumpet, signifying that the other 8 to 9 need to come through the cylinders of bubbles with their mouths open. And that's what you see on the surface there, their mouths open. So they're working together, and they are feeding on herring. So let's watch the birds here again. tug sensor.
We're surrounded. I can't move unless there's danger, and right now there's no danger. We're just kind of drifting, so just move with the whales. Move with them. I have a feeling they'll probably pop up on the port side next time. This is epic.
This is probably going to be our last stop on this journey here. We've been here almost 30 minutes, and they are protected.
last look here off the swim. Let's take a look at the rookery for the stellar sea lion. Bubba owns that section of land there. He obviously has the best. Got all those females around him. He says, yeah, I am the best. Anyways, now there are some differences between them and the Stellars. Or excuse me, them and the California sea lions. California sea lions bark, but as Bubba's there showing you, these sea lions growl. Now, I talked about how they have articulating flippers and rotating back hips. Again, they're great climbers, but they're similar to the harbor seals in that they haul out on rocks like this because, again, they can conserve their body temperature a lot better on land than in the water. But the difference between a seal and a sea lion, the difference between a seal and a sea lion is that a sea lion propels with the front flippers and steers with the back, which is opposite of a seal. Now, they're not as fast as harbor seals, but they're more agile, and they have to be. They go after things like salmon, halibut, rockfish, lingcod, flounder, all fish that tend to be a lot more agile and faster in the water. And so they have to be the same. Now, I would be doing these animals a huge disservice if I didn't tell you that they're actually on the endangered species list. And that's because during the late 1980s and the 1990s, we saw a decline in their population of 80%. Yes, 80%. At the time, we really had no idea as to why. But if you look at our 9 o'clock, just up and to the left of the sea lions, you'll see some man-made structures up there. That's put on by the Alaska Sea Life Center, a world-class research and rehabilitation center found right here in Seward. About 30 years ago, they decided to spearhead the project to try and figure out what was going on. And they figured it out. In fact, they dubbed it the junk food theory. What happened was our water temperatures warmed up about 4 degrees. Now when it did that, the fish that these animals go after dove down deeper. It made it a lot harder for the sea lions to find food. Now the sea lions didn't stop eating food, but they started to eat food that wasn't nutritionally valuable to them. Sound familiar? Anyways, this idea was the idea that these animals are eating food, but it's not really valuable to them. It's junk food essentially. And so during the winter times when things got hard, many sea lions died of either malnutrition or of starvation. So what the Sea Life Center in the state of Alaska did was they placed protection areas around these sea lions. Yes, we just saw the fox lily put up a big fish, but he didn't catch that here. He caught it offshore. This area is protected, and it's protected for them. And I'm proud to tell you that although their population is not what it used to be, it has stopped declining and has started to rise again, which means that we're going in the right direction. The port side, the thick bill and commoners are going to be right above the cave in front of us. So port side, or on the bow there, let's go take a look at the beach. Thank you.
750 feet per fish and still fly. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? The only bird that can dive deeper than the one above you is the penguin of Antarctica. But as you and I both know, the penguin in Antarctica gave up its ability to fly. Side 10 o'clock, you'll see the 6-mile-long glacier going up into the heart of ice field. Now, going to Ayala, all that means is that we're going to add about 10 to 12 minutes of extra time. We'll go by real slow. Those are those kitless murelets. They're usually together, they mate for life. I'm going to go by real slow. We've got kayakers here, and yeah, I'd really like for you to get a picture. Fishing on the starboard side. You're welcome to watch that if you'd like. I'm going to focus on getting us through the ice here. We should go on the other side where we have a little bit of room to ourselves. Okay.
find at the 1 o'clock here that that is a goat. We actually don't have sheep this far south in the park. We lose the sheep about 14 miles from Seward. Now the difference, sheep are considered Arkosa mountain goats are some of the largest goats in the world, 5.5 to 6 feet in length, on average 250 to 300 pounds. And so the male is getting upwards of 385 pounds. It only needs 2 inches of ledge, and it can go where it wants to go. You're truly looking at the best climber in the state of Alaska. Now we're gonna have more opportunities to look at this coastal mountain goat. We'll be back behind us here as we look at the glacier for the first part, and we drift down, it'll be easier to see, and then yeah, we'll reapproach and we get some more looks. So keep an eye out back behind us. There's harvest seals on the rocks, and yes, coastal mountain goat. This glacier is moving towards you 2 to 4 feet a day. Now this does a couple things for us. First and foremost, it tells us that there's still hope. But it also helps us in answering your number one question. I'll get to that in a sec. Let's talk about this idea of hope, shall we? But let me go ahead and address your number one question. You might ask, you know my number one question? Absolutely. I know that you're dying to know just how old this glacier really is. And I'm proud to tell you, well, it's my favorite answer out here. We have no idea. Yeah, I got you again. Now you might ask, even with all the technology in the world, do you still don't know?
For those sea otters, hanging out in the ice, must be nice to have the densest coat in the unlooking area than layer on the ice.
Friends, the Ayala Voyager here, and then once we're by them, we're going to pick up speed. So we want to stay outside. I hope you keep watching the glacier as long as you can, but once we get by the Ayala here, we're going to pick up speed. We're going to boogie, but we have more things to do. A great time. The Ayala Glacier. Hi, Captain Steve.
Yes, there's puffins in here too, the other type. That's one of the other reasons I love coming here. You'll see the black and white horn puffins. Now, don't get distracted by the puffins too much. We're just here for a second. I'm literally gonna come in here, sit for just a few seconds here, and then I'll back out, and we're gonna quickly have to go. But yeah, it's an amazing spot. Welcome to Spire Cove here. Soil can actually grow here thanks to an organism that's really green in color called lichen. I know that it's not a lot of time, I know really quick, but I still would be good. I wouldn't want you to miss out. Nice look at Spire Cove. Wildlife.